Start inter process communication. Do you have fair idea about inter and intra? What is the difference between inter and intra? Internet and intranet, have you heard about? And now, please don't tell me that you have no idea about internet and intranet. Who will tell me? Abhishek, are you there? Abhishek Kumar Dubey? Abhishek? Abhishek Kumar Dubey, are you there?
Yes, sir. Hello. Yes. Hello. Yes,
give
sir.
The difference between intranet and internet. Internet and intranet, what is the difference? Yes. Yes,
hello.
Abhishek. Yes, you are audible. Please speak. You can write in the chat box if you have any difficulty in speaking. Okay, let me have. Ananya, are you there? Ananya Johri, are you there? Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Do you know the difference between internet and intranet?
Sir.
Okay, leave the net, only talk about this word, inter and intra.
Sir, internet is a network, network of computers that enables the people to share information, while intranet is more local and smaller.
Give some example of this smaller thing that you are talking about. Is it related to one building only, one city, one like nation or
an organization?
Okay. So we have some answers from Chitranshu and Prakar. Let me read. Chitranshu is saying internet is a network within a city and internet is a global network. Okay. Prakhar is saying internet is restricted to some specific organizations while internet is globally used. Krishnam is saying internet is a public network whereas internet is a private network. Yes, Krishnam, very good. Internet is specific to one organization only, but internet is public domain. Prakhar is saying internet is a globally connected network of computers that enable people to share information and communication with each other. And what about intranet? Intranet means within an organization. Internet means you can go beyond your organization. As you have heard that in your colleges also, you have inter-sports meet, right? Or you can have intra-sports meet. In intra-sports meets, what will happen? That the different classes of your same college is competing in a competition. But in inter-college competition, what will happen? That college A student are there, college B students are there. These kinds of things is there. Prakhar has written, intranet, on the other hand, is a local or restricted network that enables people to store, organize, and share information within an organization. Very good, Prakhar. We have a very perfect answer. This is the exactly thing with the internet and intranet. In intranet, what we are having, local and restricted network means which is restricted to one organization only, just like your college. Krishnam is saying, for example, internet can be used by certain people and internet can be used by everyone. Ananya is saying large number of users can access internet whereas limited number of users can access intranet. Yes, it depends because it's limited number because in an organization we have limited number of employees only or we can have students only. So the thing is what I am talking about, I was pretty interested in this one first word, that is inter. What is the meaning of inter-process? That means there are two processes which are different to each other. How can they can communicate? If there is intra-process, that means we are having within a process communication. So I have given you an example of inter-college sports meet and intra-college sport meet. Okay, so are we good with this? Inter and intra? Yes or no? Cool. Are we on same page? Yes or no, please type in the chat box. Okay, cool. So what we are discussing in inter-process communication, that was the question of last class. Is it possible to have concurrency but not parallelism? Okay, so let me give you one example of parallelism. Have you seen the railway track? How is a railway track looks like? let me have my MS Paint also. Okay, let me draw some parallel lines. Okay, this is something like this, na? A railway track. Anyone can unmute yourself so that I can understand that you are understanding what I am saying. Who will help me? Yes. Okay, Firoz, you can help me. So Firoz, can you see that I have a parallel lines? Just you can think of these are the lines of a railway track. Yes or no?
Yes, yes? Sir.
Okay, so you can think that these are parallel lines. Is it so? Right?
Yeah.
So means yes, these both lines of railway track are moving in same direction, if you can think so. The train is moving in one direction and this railway track is on the way, right? So means both the lines of the railway track are in the parallel and they same. Are in same direction, right? And moving.
Yes, sir.
They are progressing simultaneously. So the characteristics with parallel thing is what? They are moving in simultaneously, means both are moving exactly with the same speed, right? So this is what an example of parallelism. Now talk about concurrency. In concurrency, what will happen? We cannot have this example for concurrency. We cannot have this railway track example for concurrency. Why? Because what happened in concurrency, we are not executing multiple tasks simultaneously. So what is concurrency? We are not executing multiple tasks simultaneously. What will happen in concurrency? That suppose there are two processes are there, P1 and P2, right? Now think about that round robin process, technique of processing the processes, right? What will happen round robin if we are switching between processes very frequently, right? Means suppose this one is P1, suppose this one is P1, and suppose this one is P2. Now we are having two processes, P1 and P2. Now we have to switch between P1 and P2 so rapidly that it gives you an illusion that P1 and P2 are executing simultaneously. But this is not so, right? Because we have seen in round robin, only one process can execute at a time in single CPU, right? If you are having a single core in CPU, means single processing power is there, then it is obvious that only one process can be served by the CPU at one time. But as you see that if we are using multiple applications and we want to use them simultaneously, then what we will do, we switch between them, right? So how operating system is doing this, it is providing you concurrency, means as you can see in round robin, it can think of it like they are executing sequentially, right? Think about that, they are, these processes P1, P2 are executing sequentially, but it is very rapidly switching between P1 and P2. Means suppose 1 second unit time is given to P1, then we switch to P2, then P1, then P2, then these P1 and P2 are progressing a little bit by the time. So this is an example of what concurrency means, both processes are progressing, but not at the same time, means they cannot execute at same time. But in parallelism, what will happen? Processes are executing at the same time, means simultaneously. So let's see how concurrency and parallelism are there. So let's understand the concept of concurrency. You have better idea. When we can say processes are in parallel, so a system is parallel if it can perform more than one task simultaneously. What I told you, that suppose if we are having dual core computer system, now one core is having computing power and another core is also having same computing power. Now we can process two processes at same time, means one process is executing in one core and second process is executing in second core, and they are executing in parallel, means they are executing simultaneously. But what happened in parallel is concurrency. A concurrent system supports more than one task by allowing all the tasks to make progress. 1 minute. Uh, Yes, so what I was telling that a concurrent system supports more than one task by allowing all the tasks to make progress. So what will happen in this scenario, you have better understand that in parallelism, what will happen? More than one task execute simultaneously, but in concurrency, what will happen? That a concurrent system support more than one task by allowing all the tasks to make progress. How? It switch between them very rapidly and gives you illusion that they are executing simultaneously. So it is possible to have concurrency without parallelism. So in a single processor, CPU schedulers were designed to provide the illusion of parallelism. Suppose we are having a single CPU, then how single CPU can perform multiple tasks at a time? It switch between those processes very rapidly and gives you an illusion that they are it is executing them in parallel. So by rapidly switching between processes in the system, thereby allowing each process to make progress. Such processes were running concurrently, but not in parallel. So you have better understanding of what is concurrency means. Multiple processes are executing, they are in progress, but they are not executing simultaneously. And what happened in parallelism? All the processes are executing simultaneously. So are we good with this parallelism and concurrency concept? You have better idea, yes or no? Are we clear with this, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we are done with this concept. So this is the crux of your second unit, that what we will study in second unit. Once we understand this concurrency thing, that not two processes are executing at the same time. Only one process can execute at one time, but we are switching very rapidly, means both the processes are progressing by the time. So if we have a very clear idea, now when we study our second unit, then you will understand those topics very easily. So let's understand what are the different type of concurrent processes and how they can communicate. So process executing concurrently in the operating system is of two type. One is independent processes. What are the independent processes which are running concurrently? A process is independent if it cannot affect or be affected by any other process. How you are independent? Suppose you are a student of BCA second year. So let me ask you, do you have any connection with mechanical third year students of Ghaziabad College? Ghaziabad AKGEC College. Do you have any connection? Are you affected by any activity by those students of mechanical third year of Ghaziabad AKGEC College? No, right? Why you cannot be affected, or you can affect those students? Because you are not sharing anything, right? You are an independent entity in Lucknow and they are independent entity in Ghaziabad. They are studying mechanical engineering, you are studying computer science in Lucknow University. So you two are different entity. So you are executing in parallel, so there is no issue. You can execute your tasks independently, you can use your resources independently, and they are using their resources independently. There is no connection, so there is no issue. If there is no sharing, then there is no issue, right? When there is an issue, because when we do share something, then there is an issue. Suppose in your house, we are mostly have only one television, right? So there is only one remote is there. So suppose there are five members in your family, then everyone wants to see their interest serial in the TV, then there is an issue, because they have to share that TV, because remote is single, then there is an issue. Suppose if there are five members in a family and everyone is having different TV in their room. Now, if there is an issue, I don't think so, right? Because you are not sharing anything. When there is a sharing, then there is an issue. Because if you want to use something at the same time, your mother wants to see something, at the same time your father wants to see something, then there is an issue, right? And then we can understand how to resolve those clashes. So this is the concept of independent process. How it is an independent? Because you are not sharing anything. A process that does not share data with any other process is independent. And in this manner, it cannot be affected by any other process, or not, or it cannot be affect any other process. And so as you have seen that there are two different type of concurrent process. First one is independent, and with the name you can identify that what is the second type, that is cooperating process. Just like your family, we are cooperating to each other. Suppose this is the time for daily soap of your mother, then you will not jump and ask for your remote of TV, right? And once the daily soap of your mother has been finished, then you came and go for some music or some cartoon, etc., whatever. You are cooperating with your family members, that everyone wants to share the resources, right? So a process cooperating, if it can affect or be affected by other processes executing in the system. Suppose your father is watching news at that time, if you want to see something, you cannot, right? Because one process is executing, and so other process has to be cooperating, and it has to wait until and unless that activity has been completed by the first process, right? So when processes are cooperating, when we are sharing the data. Thus, at any process that share the data with other processes is cooperating. So are we having a clear idea about independent processes, cooperating process? Are we clear? Yes or no? If you are sharing, then you are cooperating. If you are not sharing, then you are independent, right? This is the crux. Are we good with this? Yes or no? Are we good with this? Please write in the chat box. Are we good with this? Yes. Okay, cool. So we have very clear idea when there is an independent process, when is cooperating process. So let's see, in independent process, there is no need of communication, right? So in independent process, there is no need of communication, right? You don't want to talk to those mechanical engineering students of AKGC Ghaziabad, right? So there is no issue of communication. So when inter-process communication will happen in the case of cooperating processes only. When one process is sharing some memory space with another process, then we communicate that what is your timing of television, father, what is your watching time, what when your daily show will come, mother. Then we will be communicating, and mother will telling that the 9 to 11 is my timing, in this these are the soap I will see in on colors on Star, right? And these kind of things. So when there is a communication, when they are cooperating processes. So let's see how we can communicate in the operating system these cooperating processes. And why we are using cooperating processes? What are the reasons? First one is information sharing, computation speed up, modularity, and convenience. As you know that we don't want to spend a number of TV, more money on number of TVs, because only one TV is sufficient for five member family, right? So we can have convenience, we can have modularity, computation speed can be increased up because we are using a single resource fully, and information sharing between those cooperating processes. Now see how IPC, inter-process communication, happen. Cooperating processes requires an inter-process communication that would allow them to exchange data and information. See, till now you don't have to mug anything, right? What we have studied till now, what is concurrency, what is parallelism? You have very fair idea that parallelism, that processes are executing simultaneously. In concurrency, what will happen? They are not executing simultaneously, but it gives you an illusion that they are executing in parallel, right? You don't have to mug anything. Just think about a real world example, you will understand. And then what we have seen, that there are two type of concurrent process. First one is independent and second one is cooperating. What is independent process? If you are not sharing anything with other process, then you are independent. And in this manner, you will not either you not be affected or not you can affect any other process. And what will happen in cooperating process? You are sharing something with other processes. And when you are sharing with other processes, then you may be affected by other process or you can affect other process. So you don't have to mug anything. Just know the crux, just know the read between the lines that this is the soul of this thing, what we are studying, and you can write in your own words, right? So you don't have to mug anything. Okay, so what we are studying, inter-process communication. Cooperating process requiring inter-process communication that would allow them to exchange data and information. So now we are talking about how cooperating process can communicate to each other. Now there are two fundamental models of inter-process communication, how we can communicate. First one is shared memory, means we can have a shared memory location. Let me show you some a diagram in this. Okay, suppose we are having something, a shared memory like this. This is a shared memory. Shared memory between the whom there is a P1 process, and here we are having a P2 process. Now P1 process can use this area, and P2 process can also use this area, and this is bidirectional, means it can put something here and it can read also. It can write something in the shared memory and can read also. So in this manner they do something. 1 minute. So there are two fundamental model of inter-process communication. First one is shared memory. Second one is message passing. How message passing will happen? Let's see what is an example of message passing. Suppose we are having a process P1 here, and we are having a process P2 here. Now, how, suppose this is Ramesh and this is Suresh, how they can communicate if we are not sharing anything? Suppose how we can communicate? You can send messages, right? You can send messages like this, and it can also send you messages like this. So in this manner, we can talk to P2 and P2 can talk to P1. Means either you can pass the messages or you can use a shared memory area. So let's see how shared memory model works. In the shared memory model, a region of memory that is shared by cooperating processes is established. Process can then exchange information by reading and writing data to the shared region. As I told you that there is a region of memory, which is shared memory, which is shared by these cooperating processes, and processes can exchange information by reading and writing data to the shared region. Let's have a diagram. Here in the, this is the kernel of operating system, and in this kernel there are two processes A and B, and they can use the shared memory area as I have shown you in the diagram. In that diagram you can also draw in the examination. There is a shared memory area. Process A can communicate to this, and this is bidirectional. It can read also and write also in this shared memory. Process B can also do something like this. You can make it bidirectional. Okay, so this is the model of shared memory. Let's see how message passing works. In the message passing model, communication takes place by means of message exchange between the cooperating processes. How we are passing the messages? Here in the kernel, you can see process A and process B are there, and message Q is there. Now, M0, M1, M2, M3, these are the messages exchanged between the process A and the process B. Now, process A can send the message, process B can read, process B can send the message, and process A can read. So this is a very fundamental models of inter-process communication. Either you can use a shared memory type model, or you can do the message passing also. So we are done with this inter-process communication. Let me revise quickly this last topic of first unit. Firstly, we have understood the concept of concurrency and parallelism. Parallelism is what? All the tasks are executing simultaneously, but what happened in concurrency? We are allowing to make progress of all the tasks, but they are not executing simultaneously, right? So it is possible to have concurrency without parallelism in single CPU. In single processor also, if CPU schedulers were designed to provide the illusion of parallelism. How they are providing illusion of parallelism? By switching between processes very quickly. Okay, so there are two type of concurrent process: independent process and what? Cooperating process. Independent process are those which do not share any data with any other process. In this manner, they cannot be affected or can affect any other process. Similarly, what are the cooperating process? Cooperating process are those processes which share data with other processes, and they can be affected or can affect other process also. Now, there is no need of communication between those independent processes, but we need a communication between what cooperating process and what is the reason for using the cooperating process. We can do the information sharing, computational speed up and modularity and convenience. These are the reasons for using the cooperating processes. Now, inter-process communication model, we are using two, shared memory and message passing. In shared memory, what we do, we are using a region of memory, and with this help, we are using like communicating with one process and another process, and process can exchange information by reading and writing data to the shared region, right? And what is message passing? In message passing, process A and process B communicate through the messages. So you can see here, this is the model of this message passing technique. So we are done with unit one today. We will discuss unit two in next class. And the starting point of unit two is this today's class, that is inter-process communication. Now we will discuss what are the issues in this inter-process communication, and we will discuss in unit two that how concurrency can have some issues and how we can resolve them. Okay, so are we good with this inter-process communication? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.